Hi. I'm here today to talk about a little thing called Dark Souls 2. And I want to preface this by saying and pointing out rightly, I'm not an outwardly angry person. I'm really not. My kind of anger is the kind that I tend to bottle up inside, and it later either manifests itself in unhealthy decisions, or it comes out in an awkward manner at the wrong time. This is how I was raised. This is how I was taught. That is who I am. For any of you who follow my Twitter, I'm sure you would say this is correct. So I wanted to say that because I didn't go into this experience thinking... Actually, that's not true. I went into this experience mainly through peer pressure and mainly through the fact that I wanted to see what this experience was all about. I wanted to see what Dark Souls was. I had had nothing, I had heard all kinds of things about Dark Souls. Some good, some bad. I did not play the first Dark Souls, I watched it. This will be my later recommendation to you about this game. I hate this game. Hate this game with every fiber of my being. Is it because of the game? Not necessarily. No. In fact, I will say no. I hate this game because of what it is, what it represents, and what it has made, what it has done to the gaming genre, and what it has done to gamers. That's what I feel about this game. Now, before I go into intense detail, I'm going to list positives about the game. And in order for me to remember everything, I actually took notes. Positives about the game. A deep, deep RPG system, and a very well-made RPG system. There's no explanation about how the system works, but I'll get into that later. There's clearly been a lot of thought and a lot of effort put into making the mechanics and the design of the combat, the exploration system, you know, all that good stuff. I give it full marks for that. Okay, also, the game world is beautiful. It's gorgeous. I even played it on PS3, and I'm sure people would make fun of me for that, but it's gorgeous. There are vistas, there are incredibly deep, expansive views. I mean, also, the design of the world is beautiful. It's awesome. It's sort of a hub system that you're probably used to in role-playing games, or Western role-playing games, but not really. That's another benefit to the game, another compliment I will pay it. There are no load times. If you want to, you can literally walk from one end of the world to the other with no load times. None. You'll never survive it, but you can try. If you teleport, if you use the bonfires, of course, there'll be some load times. That happens. So, also, and here's where the crux of my argument and my issue with the game is going to be. It is engaging, and it is addictive. That's as far as I'm going to go with that compliment, and you'll see more as I talk about this more. Now I'm going to go into why this game is the most unfun, punishing, miserable experience you will ever have playing I wouldn't say a game. There are certainly a lot more unpunishing games out there. I will say a mainstream role-playing game. And you know me. I love video games. I love role-playing games. I love role-playing games. My role-playing game series is on hiatus right now, but believe me when I say I fucking love role-playing games. They are a consistent source of happiness and joy in my life. Not to be too depressing, but as you may have heard, a lot of things in my life haven't been so great the last couple years. Not gonna lie, having a family member die of cancer, not fun. You know, having to leave grad school, not fun. Having to do a lot of things that I really don't want to do. And kind of delaying the path that I thought my life was going to take. You know what keeps me going? Happy things in my life. My great friends. The support system I have. You guys, the fans. You know, your comments on Twitter, your comments on my video, that honestly, like, does so much for me. I can't even tell you guys how much I appreciate you. So then, I decided to try this game. Like I said, I wanted to see what all the hubbub was. I wanted to know what Dark Souls was. I had a lot of people pushing me to play the first one, to do a video, to do a let's play of the first one. Fuck that. Fuck that. No. I actually did capture video of a brief playthrough of the first one. No. I played about an hour and a half. Couldn't get out of the first room. Realized, no, these camera angles are ridiculous. The game is unfair. The game is cheap. The game, even forgetting the fact that the game pits you against a giant boss in the first room. That was awesome. I like that a lot. The problem is, you can't hardly win against the first boss. So I stopped. I didn't play it. I not only that, it the way that my setup was for my equipment, it would have been a nightmare to do a let's play of it, much less do a let's play of the whole thing. You know, my plan was I was going to just do a quick, you know, rage video. They wanted me to do a rage video, basically. But again, that's not me. I can't channel that much rage and make it sincere. I just can't. I don't have it in me. I don't have that kind of energy, honestly. My life, again, not to be too depressing, my life and my work eat up all of that energy that I have. And I can't do it. But this game came awfully close. It really did. Now, I'm not going to be like everybody else and just say, oh, I threw my controller around. The game is so hard. The bosses are so hard. Oh, I broke my controller. Or, oh my god, I hate my life so much because I'm playing this game and it's hard. This game is not hard. This game is not challenging. This game is cheap. It is horrendously cheap. It is an endurance test. It is a test of pain. That is all it is. Let me live blog my first experience with this game. This is Dark Souls 2 I'm talking about now. I created my character. I entered the game world. I at first am thinking, wow, this is so much more approachable. This is so much, I hesitate to say easier, but I want to say it's so much more open for someone who wants to get into the game at a pace that they're used to. There's a great tutorial mode. However, I was left with the feeling that the game is trying to make you feel emptiness. This is not a spoiler when I say this. The whole point of this game is that it's a dead world. everyone in this universe or this kingdom or what have you is dead. You know, quote every existential, you know, author or, you know, Sartre or whoever, you know, Beckett. The whole point is everything's dead. Everything's fucked. You're done. Les jeux sont faits. It's over. There's no winning. And that is what I think the authors of this game are trying to convey. They're trying to convey, to convey that you can't win. And believe me, in no part of this game do you ever feel like you're winning. Not one. So, they succeeded. You enter the game, you enter the main hub of the game, and it's this dead town, okay? Now, you follow the path. You know, you meet some characters who have the most vapid dialogue I've ever heard in my life. Bearer of the curse, bearer of the curse. Oh, hello, would you like to buy something? Please buy something. You can't even fucking hear them. They're so quiet and vapid. Okay. So, let me take a drink of water. Excuse me. Okay. So, I entered the main hub of the game. I followed what seemed to be, and it wasn't obvious, but what seemed to be the path to go. I enter the first area, and again, it's gorgeous. It's beautiful. I'm thinking, this ain't gonna be so bad. And then I run into the first enemy in the game, a 15-foot-tall iron knight with a sword as tall as I am, taller than I am. I mean me, I'm not even talking about the game character, that hits me once and I'm dead. Welcome to the game, motherfucker. You died. It gets pasted across the screen. And I'm thinking, okay, you know, we're going to do this on the first enemy of the game. Let's do this game. Let's Rochambeau here. Now, first of all, what the fuck? The first enemy in the entire game, you cannot beat with legit tactics. Can't. The only way you can possibly best this knight-like character is to be cheap. Is to throw shit at it from a distance. Or roll around it. Because I'm thinking to myself, okay, this game is trying to be punishing and trying to be realistic. The game is trying to be realistic, mind you. I have issues with that. So I'm sitting here and I've got my shield. I'm kind of a knight-like fighter build. And I'm like, I got my shield here. I'm doing all right. But I'm thinking to myself, realistically, okay, there's no point in blocking because with a sword that big, with the size of this enemy, blocking is pointless. Blocking is pointless. So I don't even try blocking. I try dodging. I try rolling around it. And first of all, it completely defies physics. Completely defies physics in that it can literally start swinging, like going like this, coming down like that. Like, it'll be halfway through this animation, and I'll have dodged it, I'll have rolled around, and yet it magically turns and hits me, and I'm dead. The hit detection in this game is fucking ridiculous. Completely unfair and incredibly cheap. Honestly, the first day I'm playing this, I spend 2 to 3 hours just trying to beat the first enemy I see! That is so fucking wrong! That is horrible! You can't go into a game. You can't! You can't start a game by beating the player down within the first goddamn 10-20 minutes of it! You can't! I'm sorry, you can't. You have to bring the player in. You have to get them to want to play your game. I was ready to return the game within the first 2 hours. I was done. I was like, no, I'm not doing this. There's no point. There's no fucking point. I was like, what the hell is the point? I can't even beat the first goddamn enemy. How am I supposed to beat the first boss? So I was like, okay. I'm clearly not supposed to fight this enemy yet. I get it. So I'll dodge it. I'll escape it. It's very slow moving. It seems to work on MMORPG terms in that you have to be within a certain area to attract its attention. So with games like this, you often have to lure one kind of enemy out. And that's another thing. A lot of this game is designed as MMORPGs. I don't like MMORPGs. So I was kind of behind the eight ball from the beginning of this experience. But that's neither here nor there. I'll talk about that later. So, and I just want to continue live blogging my first experiences with this game, and then I'll go point by point by point, exactly what I'm getting into. So, I dodged it. I rolled around it. Fine. Eventually, I actually beat it. When I decided to just completely say fuck it and use cheap tactics, I beat it. You shouldn't have to use cheap tactics on the first fucking enemy you see. I don't care. That is wrong. That is horribly wrong. You will never convince me of that. Oh, but this game is supposed to be challenging. It's supposed to be punishing. Fuck you! That is not challenging. That is putting up a giant middle finger to anyone who wants to play this game. That's all it is. So, let me continue. So I dodged. I dodged them. I ran into three of them in a giant open area. I dodged them again. I ran into the first boss that I found. And honestly, it wasn't any harder than the other enemies. Problem number one, a boss is supposed to be significantly stronger than the enemies in its area. I'm sorry, you will not convince me otherwise. I nearly beat the boss. The boss was about as difficult, as easy, whatever you want to say, as the first fucking enemy in the game. Again, you can see why I just about quit and returned. But no, this isn't even the cream. This isn't even the big problem with this. You're gonna die a lot in this game. Everybody knows that about Dark Souls. I knew that about Dark Souls. That's the point. When I posted a picture on Twitter of the actual, like, of me buying the game, the majority of the response was, hey, get ready to die! And it was like, you know, that's cute, that's fun, I get that. So, you know, I went into this, honestly, and this is my point here. I know I'm rambling, I know I'm a mess. My point here is that I truly went into this wanting to enjoy this game. I did. I just want to remind you of that. Anyway. Where was I? I don't even know where I was. Anyway. Oh, I got it. Now, this game, I've been told, is not like the first Dark Souls. It is more like the first Demon Souls. In that, every time you die, considering the fact that you are already, every character in this universe, in this world, is already dead. So you would think, and again, this is playing on video game tropes. This is what they're doing. They think they're so clever, and they think they're so, you know, the people who made this game, there's a special place in hell for the people who made this game. So every time you die, every time you get killed, your health bar gets reduced. You're already tiny, tiny health bar that is capable of being ended in one sword stroke. And I had good armor on. I was playing a warrior. Ended in one sword stroke. And if not one sword stroke, one hit. Because what happens when you're hit once is you're so stunned that you can't move, and then they do a combo and you're hit at least two or three times more and you're dead. If you survive, so that's why I say you're killed in one hit, basically. So, like, you're, so anyway, your hit points get reduced. Your hit point max gets reduced. This will go until you're 50% down in health. You know, your character becomes more grotesque. You literally look like a rotting zombie corpse. And see, on the one hand, conceptually, I like that. It makes sense. You lose more and more of your humanity. Here's the problem with that. In order to restore your hit points, you have to use limited items. First of all, already a dick enough move to reduce your hit points. I get why they do it, but it's already a dick enough move that I'm not even going to talk about it anymore. But then they make the items that restore it very limited. They're either limited in the amount of times you can purchase them, if you can find the sellers that sell them, or they're a random drop. I got lucky. I found quite a few of them. So really, in the end, I was okay. But, you know, a less smart player will never have a chance. And that's the biggest... I'm saving that for later. That will be my end rant. That will be my final last part to this. So, long story short, too late. It turns out I went the wrong way. It turns out that instead of going straight, you were supposed to turn around the second you entered the main hub and follow that path. First of all, fuck you. Second of all, what are you doing? You're literally making people buy this game and return it because they think that they can't even get past the first level. That's wrong. That's wrong. Now, here is what the fans of this series will say, and, you know, I will say I understand why people like this game. I don't like it, and I'll talk about that more later, but I am not here saying, if you like this game, I hate you. I don't. I have many friends who love this game, who love this genre. Again, I will get more into that later. I'm not going to take this away from you. I hate this series and what it represents. You can like it. You can like whatever the heck you want. As long as it's legal and consensual, you can like whatever the hell you want. It's America. America, right? So, just fuck off with that. Like, so, they're trying, and this is what the fans say. Anyway, this is what the fans say. Well, they're not going to baby their audience. They don't want to get the casual gamer. They want the hardcore gamer. Why would you limit yourself to that? Why would you limit your target audience to that? That's asking for your game to fail. That's poor business strategy. Number two, games are supposed to be fun! They're supposed to be fucking fun! They're supposed to be an escape! They're supposed to be enjoyable! None of this game is, very little of this game is enjoyable! I'm sorry, but I am not a casual gamer. Like, gaming is part of my identity. This game destroyed a part of my soul. Like, it's entirely appropriate that in this game you collect souls. That souls is the experience, the economy in this world. It's everything. Speaking of which, this is another real issue I had with this game. And it's, in this case, it's a love-hate issue. Okay? Every time you defeat an enemy, you get souls. You collect these little white clouds that are called souls. You can find souls, you can pick them up, and you can use them to give you more souls. It's a really, like I said, it's a great system. This game is not bad because of its system. It's a fantastic system. It's rewarding. If you stick it out, the system, not the game, mind you, the system is rewarding. So, about the souls. So you might be thinking to yourself, like any classic 80s video game, you can die as much as you want. It doesn't matter. You can always start again. You always go back to your save point or your continue point. And this is what I think the designers of this game were trying to do. They were trying to make death a more harrowing and terrifying thing. Because the way that this game works, and the way that the original Dark Souls, and I'm probably guessing Demon Souls, and anybody watching this probably knows, again, this is not a spoiler, as you go collecting souls, you can purchase things, or you can level your character up. You can increase a stat. And again, the system is great. I love the system in the game. However, there is a risk to gathering too many souls. If you die, if your character dies, there is a blood stain made upon the ground, wherever you die, or, you know, thankfully, on a ledge, like if you fall off, or if you walk into lava, or whatever. There is a, and the game is very fair about this, so I'll give it props for that, there is a little blood stain where all of your souls will be sitting, waiting for you, when you respawn. When you respawn, you're down to zero souls, right? So, you could have been spending, like I have several fucking times in the game, gathered thousands. Hundreds of thousands of souls in some cases. So, you die once. No big deal. You can regain those souls, and this is very forgiving in many ways. I honestly give the game full props for being reasonable. I mean, I'm having to stretch straws wow. I'm having to really, really stretch and really try to appreciate this game. Look at this, I'm fucking shaking from that viewpoint. To appreciate the fact that the game was that reasonable. That the game was going to allow you to be able to recover your souls. So, you can recover your souls. You can go back and get them. As long as you go back and touch your bloodstain before you get killed again, you can recover all those souls. However, if you get killed before you touch those souls, they're gone. Gone forever. Poof! The effort of, you know, hours. Hours of work. Gone in an instant. Like, I know according to my game, I've captured 4, 5, 6, maybe almost 10 million souls. I've put, just so you people fucking know, I've put over 200 hours into this game. I gave this game more than a legit chance, okay? I really did. But, and I know what you're saying, well, you shouldn't have carried that many souls, or, well, that's the risk you take, but that's not right. It's just not right. It's punishing. It's punishing. It's so frustrating. It's horrible. It's not fun. Someone who may or may not watch this video makes the argument that a game needs to be, or artwork. He even said artwork. Like this game is artwork. He said that artwork is supposed to be engaging, not fun. So just because something captures your attention makes it art, or makes it worthwhile. So are wars good? Are wars worthwhile? Are wars art? Is the fact that someone running at you with a knife, is that art? It requires my attention. I must give it my attention in order to save my life. Or, you know, is the fact that my foot is on fire, is it engaging? Yes. If I don't pay attention, I'm going to burn alive. That doesn't make it good. That doesn't make it fun. That doesn't make it worth my time. Okay, is it worth my time to save my life? Of course it is. And that's the problem with this game. The essential problem with this game is that it is not challenging. It is cheap. So, vis-a-vis the lines of losing tons and tons of souls, I'm not talking about going into direct combat, being stupid, getting overwhelmed, and getting killed. First of all, side rant, if you face two or more enemies at a time, you're dead. Game over. Game over. You're dead, man. It's over. However, there are many areas in this game where there are archers perched in the distance, and you can be as agile and as good a combatant as possible, as smart a combatant as possible, and yet you will get hit with an arrow that does way more damage than it should and kill you. This happened to me when I had about, 220,000 souls. I wanted to slit my throat. No, that's not true. This game. Alright, what else? Okay, so, now that I've given you a brief experience of the game, I'm going to go into the issues that I really have with it, and why I'm imploring you. I'm begging you. If you haven't played this game, and I'm literally, I may as well be on my knees and I'm begging you, don't support this. Don't support this game. Don't support it. Don't do it. It's you might think you want to play it. You may even be listening to me saying this and you're like, oh shit, if he's this angry, I gotta play this game. Don't. Just don't. I can't take that time back. Like, there are 200 hours of my life that are just gone, that I'm never going to get back, much like when I lost my souls. I feel like this game has literally taken away part of my soul, and it's not so much that I'm angry, more than I'm just sad. I'm miserable because of this game. This game is literally making me, the fact that I can sit here and I can say that I hate, and when I say hate, I fucking mean hate. Like, I want to destroy that game. Hold on one second. This game, I'm gonna return it. I'm gonna trade it in. I'm gonna get some kind of value for this. I don't want this in my house. I don't want this in the same place that I sleep at night, which I'm not going to be able to avoid in a couple of months, well, a month and a half, when I move into a new place. Hi, roommate! I have never returned a game. I've never traded in a game. I like games. I enjoy collecting them. I am proud of the collection that I have of games. I'm returning this. I'm returning this as soon as I'm done with this fucking review. I'm returning this. I don't want it in my house. I'm done. I'm done with that game. Okay. You know what? I'm actually gonna go take a break because I'm so tired. I'm so angry right now. I need to take a break. I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back. I had to go and take a lunch break. Seriously, I literally just had to go out, get some fresh air, and get lunch, because I was losing my mind, and I was having maybe 2-3 Twitter arguments at once over this game and other games I have serious issues with. Anyway, in fact, I had someone talking to a friend of mine just now, and they were like, maybe you should move on from Dark Souls. And I'm like, that's why I'm doing this. This is my closure, because Lord knows the game didn't provide any kind of catharsis or closure. Other issues I have with this game. There's no story. Now, not every game has to have story. I understand that. Don't even start. I understand that. I enjoy games that have great stories. That is probably the biggest thing that drives me, honestly, to think, to be engaged in a great video game and a great role-playing game, is because of the story. It's because I care about the characters. It's because I want to see the story come to a conclusion. It doesn't even have to be a happy one, necessarily. I mean, look at me. I played all the Silent Hill games. very few of them come to happy endings. Well, unless you, you know, unless you manage to get the happy ending, which is very rare. But at least it had an arc. Dark Souls has no arc. There's no development. And I know, you get the story through the dialogue. No, you don't. You get individual accounts of their experiences in the world. That is not a story. There is no overarching narrative. There's no narrative. It's just an experience. Okay, so for the people who argue, it's just an experience, you don't need a story. Maybe in this case you don't. It would have been nice. It would have been nice to have something. Anything. Good. Anything. Not even good. Anything satisfying. Happen. At the end of this game. Oh, and that's another thing. The argument for this game is, it's so ball-bustingly hard, and it's not, it's cheap, it's so ball-bustingly hard that when you win, it's orgasmic. It's, you're so happy that you've won, or it's, the bosses are so hard that it's practically orgasmic when you win. No. No, it's not. It's relief. It's relief from the end of suffering, from the end of torture. Now, I could go on a whole different tangent about our society and our inborn belief that when it comes to relationships and unhealthy relationships, freedom from being tortured or abused in any way, means happiness. There is so much wrong with that. There is so much that is so unbelievably wrong with that. I am paralyzed with fury that that kind of thing exists, that that belief is ingrained in our society now. And you know what? This game personifies that. There's no accomplishment. There's no accomplishment because it requires cheap tactics to beat any boss. Whether it be roll around it such that it literally can't touch you, summon other characters to help you fight. And honestly, if I couldn't have done that, I would have never finished the game. I tried to avoid summoning other characters to help me fight. And in the end, it's just getting other bodies in the room such that the boss is distracted by them and focuses their attention on them, that you can then beat down the boss while it's paying attention to others. That's the only way to beat most of the bosses in the game. That's the only way. Like, grind until you're literally level 200. I was level 200 when I was finished with this goddamn game. And I didn't see any other way possible. I did not. I probably finished the game around level 190, I think. And I started to do extra stuff, and I eventually was just like, no, this is stupid. This is pointless. I'm done. I've beaten this game. I'm done. I don't want to touch it anymore. I don't want to play it anymore. I'm done. Okay. I've beat around the bush long enough. I'm going to tell you, essentially, the real crux of why I hate the fact that this game exists and what it has done to role-playing gamers, to gamers in general. I hate what this game has done to the gaming community. The argument that the majority of the fans of this genre make when people like me rightly point out, this game's kind of cheap, it's kind of unfair. What do they say? Oh, it's because it doesn't baby you like other games do. And I respond with, no. The game breaks every rule. The game sets rules and then breaks its own rules. The game flies in the face of every single adventure game, role-playing game, whatever, trope. Yeah, that's because it's unique. No, it's because it's fucking trolling you. I don't like being trolled. Nobody likes being trolled. Speaking of which, another huge issue I have with this game is the forced multiplayer. The PvP. You will be entering different areas of the game. You will probably be on your last leg, a little bit of health left, many times. And all of a sudden, you'll see a friendly little message on the bottom that says, "You have been invaded by X." No choice in the matter. Someone has decided to invade your world and force multiplayer gameplay on you. Fuck you! I'm playing a single-player game. I clearly don't want a multiplayer experience. Leave me alone and let me play my goddamn game.
Why don't you just win the...
Because people are fucking overpowered. There's lag. There's so many problems with this. And you don't have a choice.
We'll play it in offline mode. Don't sign in.
Then the whole point that a lot of you are making about this game is defeated. Fans of this game, a lot of them, say it's hard, it doesn't provide you instructions, what the hell, because it wants you to talk to other gamers who play the game. It encourages community, someone once said to me. It encourages you to cheat, okay? I will not believe that you can actually beat this game without cheating, consulting a walkthrough, looking up answers to puzzles, boss fights, whatever, or co-oping with other players that you can summon to be bosses. You can't do it. If you've never played this genre before, like I had not, you cannot beat the game by yourself. That is so wrong. That is so fucking wrong. You know? Okay, call me antisocial, whatever. I don't enjoy playing multiplayer games. You know why? Because I suck at them. Because I don't play them very often. Thus, every time I try to get into multiplayer gaming, it just frustrates me. Because there's no way that someone who doesn't normally play multiplayer games can possibly compete against 8 to 15-year-olds who have nothing else to do with their time. You can't. You just can't. And it's so goddamn frustrating. I don't even try. I literally don't even try. I want to play my single-player games. Games began as, one could argue, a single or maybe two-player genre. Pong required two players. If you didn't play another human, you played the computer. Single-player experience. A role-playing game marketed as a single-player experience should not include forced multiplayer! And I can hear you. You know, I know what you're thinking. I think I've already said this, but I put 200 hours of my life into this game. So, all of you, a lot of you, I'm sure, are probably thinking, well, you must have liked it or you wouldn't have played it. If you dislike it, stop playing it. The game makes you want to defeat it. You want to make it hurt. That is not, I want to beat this game because it's challenging. That is, I want revenge against this thing that is abusing me. I want this thing to suffer as much as I am suffering. Yes. I wanted to beat this game because it was personal. You know the last time I played a game that made it personal, that I wanted to beat it? This game! Catherine! One of the best and yet most painful games I've ever played. You want to play a game that's challenging, not cheap, play this game. You want to play a game that is challenging, not cheap, and has a story? Play this game. Oh, a game that actually has a story. Novel fucking idea. Okay, other issues I had, just so I don't forget. The fact that there's no instructions, there's no indication of anything. There is a help mode, for example. As you're looking at your stats and equipment, I didn't even notice that there was a button you could press to get an explanation of what it was. Because it's so goddamn tiny on the screen, you can't see it! There's no way to sell the endless weapons and armor that you will get. And I mean, I had 30, easily 30, versions of every piece of armor there was in the game. Pointless. If you're not going to equip it, there's no point. There's zero point in having it. At least the game allows you to store them. There's a couple of full motion videos in this game. A couple! I know a lot of people are like, oh, I don't like FMV, I'd rather just play the game. Role-playing games should have full motion video. They're works of art. Show off the art. God damn it. The weapons and armor can break. This is never fun in any game. Stop it! Oh, but it's realistic. Realistic! Realism in a game with fucking giants and fucking giant dragons. Realism! Okay. Now, despite all of my issues with the game itself, here is the thing that utterly infuriates me and depresses me about this genre. These games have done nothing but bring the already incredibly annoying and frustrating elitism that is already present in a lot of gamers these days. It has become essentially on the internet, among people who play them, it's become practically schoolyard bullying. It is a way for people who, as gamers, you know, as a gamer, I was mocked. I was made fun of. I was bullied as a kid because I was a nerd, because I am a nerd. Now, these days, being nerdy has become a little bit more acceptable. We have smartphones, we have computers that can do things that no one ever imagined. So if you're, like, the new nerd is a not nerd. The new nerd is the jock. You know, the, do you even lift, bro? The Jersey Shore kind of, you know, complete joke of a human being. Where it's, you know, the whole point is everything has been reversed. These days, especially when it comes to first-person shooters, Call of Duty, Battlefield, all that shit. Yeah. Oh, noob, haha, totally owned your face, noob. Like, I'm a good, you know, I can beat your ass in multiplayer. That makes me better than you. You know, and that's fine. You want to have that? Go play multiplayer online. Go play Call of Duty. Go play Battlefield. You can have that. You can get that. Leave my goddamn role-playing games out of it. Let me have that one thing that is consistent joy and happiness and untouched, unsullied by your goddamn want for vengeance against bullies and jocks that made fun of you and beat you up when you were a kid. But no! Now, those same people are being made from this game! You have these people who are like, oh, the game doesn't baby you. Or, oh, if you don't beat this game, you're not a real gamer. Or, oh, maybe this game is too hard for you, bro. Do you even game, bro? Do you people even see how ridiculous you're being? How can can you have let this happen? How? Just how? It makes me want to cry. Like, it's destroying my favorite thing in the world. It's killing it. It's killing the genre. If this is where the role-playing game genre is going, I'm done. I'm fucking done. And I will have literally almost nothing left. That's why I hate this game. That in a nutshell, is why I hate this game. Games are supposed to be things that bring us together. Games are supposed to be things that are fun, that are enjoyable, not frustrating, punishing, and cheap to the point of wanting to throw your controller into the wall nearly every couple of minutes. If you have a boss battle that is cheap, that is one thing. Every single encounter in this game is cheap. There's nothing about this game that is gradual. There's nothing about this game that ramps up the difficulty. I would argue that this game is not even difficult. I basically brute forced my way through it. I grinded like a fucking fiend. I was level 200. That was how I was beating enemies. That was how I was beating bosses. Because I didn't want to have to use cheap tactics on every single enemy. Sorry, that's not right. That is just not right. I've played easy, insultingly easy role-playing games. It's called Final Fantasy Mystic Quest. It was so easy, it was insulting. I like those games, however, because it still wants you to enjoy the experience. Dark Souls doesn't want you to enjoy the experience. Dark Souls throws a middle finger and drives it up your ass every single time you play it. It's minimalistic. It's dead. It's overly emo. Oh my gosh. The existentialism in this game is just literally hitting you in the face every single second of the experience. God, I'm so angry, I'm spitting. That's it. I've got nothing left. This was my closure. Now this is enjoyment. This is happiness. This is happiness because I know I never have to play that fucking miserable experience ever again. I will never play a Dark Souls game ever again. You want to know what you do with this game? You watch it. You watch someone else play. Live if you can do it. On YouTube if you have to. You know why? Because then at least you can have Schadenfreude. You can enjoy the fact that someone else who is playing this game is literally being broken into a complete shadow, shell, hollow, if you will, of the person that they once were. The single breaking down of their entire sanity into a miserable, broken thing. Because that's what America is about, am I right? Watching train wrecks. This game will wreck you. You will feel as if you are literally being broken down. You know why I finished this game? Come here. You know why I finished this game? Because I didn't want these same fucks who are so snobbish and so, oh, I'm the best at this game. I beat it in 20 hours. So that I could cut you off from even beginning to say, well, you didn't finish the game. So you could, I beat this game so that I could make this rant. Because if I did not beat this game, I would have nothing to stand on. Nothing. And if I had let this game beat me, I would have regretted it for the rest of my life. Because that something this loathsome, that something like this exists, and it beat me. But it fucking didn't. I beat this game. It's over. It's done. I almost platinumed it too. I wanted to platinum the goddamn thing. But then I was like, no, it's there's no point.
Oh, well, you didn't beat it because you didn't platinum it.
Fuck you! No, just... I can't get those 200 hours back. They're gone. Save yourself. Do not play this game. Watch it, and you'll have a blast. You'll have a fucking ball. Do not play this game. And I'm too late. I mean, I'm sure there's 3, 4, 5 already in the works. Because, hey, if I fell for it, I'm sure there are millions of people who fell for this farce. It's just... games are supposed to be fun. They are. They're not supposed to be miserable. Life is miserable enough, man. I didn't need this. And none of you need this. So I beg you, don't play this game. Don't support this. Just don't. If you're like me, and you've already been through it, and practically have post-traumatic stress syndrome-like symptoms from this game, I'm sorry. I'm right there with you. We're brothers and sisters in a way that not too many other people can say they are. I'm saying this because I like you guys. I love you. You know, you give me reason to keep putting my stupid ass in front of a camera and talking. You give me reason to keep playing games and having fun. At a time in my life when not a whole lot is going right. I'm gonna be a little bit emo here and just say it. You keep me going, but this game just, it tries to break you. It tries to break you. In a way, it did. But in another way, I know that I came out. There is light at the end of the tunnel. If you're currently playing this, just keep going. Like Winston Churchill once said, if you're going through hell, keep going. And with that, I'm done. Thank you for watching. My name is Cronos 006. Signing off. I'm gonna go and return this game. See you later.